Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. The human body seems like a pretty fragile thing. Your bones can break after falling just a few feet. One piece of bad food and you're hugging the toilet for hours. While your body can be pretty fickle in those kinds of ways, it can actually withstand some pretty insane stuff. So, how far can we push our bodies? While all humans have similar makeups, each body has different thresholds for different extremes. So just because one person was able to do some crazy feat, that does not mean that your body can too. And we definitely don't suggest you try. Seriously. Humans have reached some insane heights, depths, distances, and temperatures to prove the human body is one rock-solid machine. Take Wim Hof, for example, aka the Iceman. He's hiked Everest in just shorts, ran a half marathon barefoot in the snow, and taken the longest ice bath recorded, almost 2 hours. His practice of meditation, specific breathing techniques, and regular exposure to cold temperatures has been proven to help prep the body for strenuous activity and boost immune system functionality. How much cold one person can handle before it gets deadly depends on a lot of things, from the person's health to whether they're wet or dry. But as far as core body temperature goes, it's generally thought that anything below 70 degrees Fahrenheit is deadly. The lowest temperature ever recorded that didn't end in death, 56.7 degrees. Ugh. Can someone hand me a turtleneck sweater? I'm getting cold just thinking about that. Heat is similar in the sense that every situation is different. Humidity, personal limits, access to water all affect how likely you'd be to kick the bucket. But the body starts to overheat and heat stroke sets in when your body temperature exceeds 103 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, actually, I'm gonna take the sweater off now, thanks. And dying from heat is more common than you may think. Almost 700 Americans die from it every year. Some athletes can do some pretty extreme stuff too. Meet Dean Karnazes. This guy ran 350 miles in one go. I have no idea how he went to the bathroom and honestly, I don't want to know. Regardless, a great accomplishment. Another human with superhuman strength? Eddie Hall. He holds the record for the heaviest deadlift at 1,100 pounds. I tried opening my fridge a couple of minutes ago and now my arm hurts. So I guess we all can't be winners. This lift did burst a ton of blood vessels in his head and almost killed him, so don't try this. What about drinking water? Just like all the other things we've mentioned, this time frame depends on a lot, especially how much fluid has been expelled by sweating, urinating, and exhaling. 3 days is the most commonly cited number for the average person, but one guy allegedly survived 18 days without water. Then there's food. Again, it's hard to define the threshold for everyone, but 3 weeks is said to be the average length of time a human can go without it. The longest anyone ever went before dying was 74 days in 1920. You humans are really strong and can withstand so much. Sometimes I do wish I was human. Although I can do this, 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 and make this happen. So, it's not all bad. So what do you think is the coolest thing the human body can do? Let us know in the comment section below, or tell us, what should we talk about next? And if you enjoyed this video, check out the video we did on what performance-enhancing drugs can do to the human body.
In one study, blood doping increased an athlete's endurance by 34%, and in another, an athlete was able to run 8 kilometers on a treadmill 44 seconds faster than before.
As always, my name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.